Hey y'all, it's Kathy, and welcome to our channel. Today, actually tonight, because it's like 10:30 at night or something, and I just suddenly decided, hey, I want to film a video. I've had these products on my desk next to my laptop for probably a month. Yeah. And I've been wanting to show them to y'all. My dog is like choking. Oh, okay. Anyways. And so I'm just gonna show them to y'all now. Put them on my face. Right now, all I have on is my Milani concealer. And I put on some of this, some of this sexy mother pucker extremely plump from, oh, XL. From Soap and Glory. There it is. It tastes like chocolate cake and it tingles, which I like. Anyways, moving on. So, on Instagram, I won a little giveaway because I enter all the giveaways. Well, not the giveaways that have stuff that I don't want. But other than that, yeah, I enter all the giveaways. I have no shame. And I enter all the giveaways on YouTube too. So I won this nifty little palette from NYX. Oh, it's upside down. It's called the Go-To Palette. And yes, it is, because it's an entire face palette. You got your shadows, and you got your blush, and you got your bronzer, and you got your highlighter. I just realized it doesn't come with a brush. That's cool. Those usually a waste of space anyways. And I also won this NYX eyeshadow brush. It's number 16, in case anybody's wondering, because it doesn't have a name. Is what it looks like, and I like it because it's not too fluffy, it's just a tad bit dense. I don't like my brushes to be too fluffy, my crease brushes. So yes, another thing I wanted to show you all was this. I know I'm just a cheese. It's an NYC palette. Ah, gag. Can't find NYC products anymore. Do they still have NYC in other places? Is it just my city that like doesn't sell it anymore? But it was randomly hanging in the Rimmel section of Target, and I saw it and I made a beeline to it. And then when I was cleaning out my stuff the other day, I found a palette like this in there, and I got sad. I was like, oh, I already had it. But it turns out it's in different colors, but it's the same concept as a highlighter, and it's like a cream highlighter, and it has a eyeshadow base, and then the shadows, and they tell you where they're supposed to go, etc. And I also, from Sally's, I got an self-adjusting blush, so we shall test that out today, tonight, yeah. And I also have, God pray for me, an ombre lip wand from Wet n Wild. I'm very confused by this, very, very confused, and I will explain it when I attempt to do it, unless I chicken out. So, I have a mirror over here, in case, you know, you see me going like this. And, so, okay. Oh, I'm forgetting. Because I did not set my blush yet with powder. Because I found this at Walgreens. It is actually Mexican makeup. It is a shine control powder. Polvo compacto con control de brillo. So it's powder in natural matte. So it actually looks prettier in person. Aspexia, that's the brand. This was the actually only like makeup product, and the rest were what's it called? Skincare products. But yeah, I thought that was really cool. So let me open this up so I can set my under eyes. And my trusty setting brush. This brush is my favorite setting brush. It's got hair in it now because I put it on the. And it's a Conair brush and it cost me 50 cents and I love it. Pleasant smell. All right, moving on. Think this light we may turn off. We may see how that goes. Okay, so we have two eyeshadow palettes. I think I'm gonna use both of them. Okay. Gonna use the primer from here. What? Oh, it actually has a little plastic cover on top that has all the instructions. So I'll just take this primer. Okay, no big deal. Close it up. And I'm going to use the eggplant shade from here. And I'll take the next crease brush, I can speak. Have to put it in there twice. I mean, do two. Isn't it an interesting brush? All right, I'm gonna go into the next palette now. Take this packing brush and use some of this. I hate doing this. Some of this light purple. Just pack it on my lid. I love this brush. Packing. It's one of the my black unicorn brushes I got in a set called Midnight something or other. I don't remember. And then I'm gonna clean it off, and I'm gonna take this gold, no, this gold shade, and try to it into my inner. That's pretty. That is pretty. Okay. So I didn't bring a brush small enough. I'm gonna take this color over here and highlight my brow bone. That worked! And then I'm going to take the same little brush but the other end and take this white shade and highlight my inner corner. Yeah, you can't really see that. Okay. So, moving on to blush. Ta-da! Of course, I don't have it open. Give me the scissors. Give me the scissors, man. And I'll take my. Where is it? Here you are. This is a very soft blush brush. And I totally went home because that's what I'll do. There's a little pink on my face. I'm afraid of what's gonna happen since I went so ham. Making the faces. Okay. Well, we'll just let that do its work, I guess. And I have to put it back on. Okay, so since this is a whole face palette, I'm going to try the bronzer. Oh my God, there is tons of kick up. That was something. We need a little bit of this powder that's left. Powder. Was not expecting. I think this might be just a little too dark for me. Having trouble blending it out. I didn't bring a fluffy brush. Oh, so too bad. That'll do. So the NYC palette has a little highlighter, a little cream highlighter. So I'll use that and then I'll set it with the highlighter from the NYX palette. Shall we? We shall. Okay, I guess I'll just use my finger. Oh, that's nice. What are you doing? That's a good highlighter, y'all. Stop it. Yes, I was talking to my aunt. It's what I do. It's what I do. Do y'all see any change in the blush? So why don't I add a little bit of the NYX blush while I'm doing the highlight as well. Okay, I will do... What should I do first? I'll do the blush. Don't see nearly as much kick up. You gotta go. Lots of kick up, y'all. Wow. Don't know. Hard to tell. Hard to tell. Oh, I think it did add to the other one. Okay, and then remember I did my video on the Essence mascaras, and I said that I liked the long lashes one. I forget what it's called, but I have totally changed my mind, and I can admit when I changed my mind. I have turned to the curl and hold side. I think it makes my eyes look so much bigger. So much bigger. So that's what I'm going to put on right now so y'all can see. Now these are my sad lashes. These are my sad lashes, and they look gorgeous. And these are my happy lashes. These mascaras, both of them, they really wrap around your lashes and do what they're supposed to do. That's why I love them, and that's why I use them. Step one is this. See, it's brown. And step two is this, red. But what confuses me is that they're both the same size. Like, I would understand if you lined your lips with a smaller color. I think I might reverse it and put the red inside first, and then the brown. Is that crazy? Because I'm doing it. See, that wasn't so hard. Now, what I think is the hard part. God, that wasn't hard at all. Did I do it right? I think it looks nice. Kind of trippy. All right, I did it, y'all. I'm so proud of myself. I'm a pat on the back. Okay, so that was me trying out a whole bunch of stuff. The self-adjusting blush. The NYX palette. The eyeshadows are really nice. So are these. Except watch out for the kick-up, y'all. Lots of kick-up. I really liked this one. Good color. I mean, there's good pigmentation. And this was fun. And I'm on the fence about this brush. I gotta play with it more. So, all in all, I give it a 2 thumbs up. Hope y'all liked this video. It's late. The dog's waiting for me to get back in bed. I need to go to sleep, actually. And yeah, if you're new here, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Yay! Now, thanks for watching. See y'all later. Bye.